communication is everything. When we come out here for an emergency call, there's any number of agencies responding at the same time. If we can get to the scenes more efficiently with better information, it's only going to make for better results. Then once we're on the scene, if we can communicate with one another better, more clearly, safer, it's going to be a safer, more successful operation for everybody.
We're sitting right here where Air Florida went into the river that fateful winter day. And the cooperation between the jurisdictions, radios, command status, all that was not there. So there was a total breakdown of command, total breakdown of operations and what was going on and who was taking care of what. With the Marine operations during 9/11, some of the things they could provide, obviously the city was gridlocked. So they could provide transportation past that gridlock to critical personnel. Multiple jurisdictions from Virginia, DC, Maryland, everybody converging on one operation. Without being on the same page at the same time of an incident, of a large scale incident, you're gonna have duplication of efforts, you're gonna have things go awry. Being able to take information from here and just distribute it throughout the jurisdictions would be incredible.
We're out here saving lives, we need to know what's going on, how many victims are out in the water, how many people need to be rescued. So Captain is communicating with the other jurisdictions and he's communicating back to us.
Right now, we do have the capabilities with our ghost system on board, where even right now we're being viewed, and if someone was on land with their smartphone, could actually see what we're doing and how we're operating. Having live, having it in real time, you know, not broken up like it is now, absolutely. Anytime you have your command structure that can have a true vision of what is going on with the incident live, you can't even measure it, what it means to command and communications as far as having that information.